Hello everyone, welcome to PyLearning. In today's video, we are going to talk about Python class and class attributes. Now, this is the second video in the series of object-oriented programming tutorials in Python. If you haven't watched the first video, make sure to go ahead, click the I link above, watch the first video and then come back. I'm sure you will get a good understanding of what object-oriented programming is and what concepts are we going to focus on in this series of tutorials. Also, after you watch this video, make sure to check out the poll again in the I link and give me feedback on how you found this video. This feedback will help me in making better videos for you in the future. So, before we jump into how to work with classes in Python, first, we need to question and understand why even we need classes in the first place. I mean, what is the point of learning something if we are not going to use it, if it is unnecessary? So let's first understand what are the advantages of using classes in Python. I have a really good example to demonstrate this to you. Check out this variable called carInfo. This is a nested list and has a bunch of information. What seems like car information, as in the name of the car, and some numbers that are somewhere related to the car. But you have no idea what it represents. Basically, this data structure is not able to convey full picture about the data it holds. Now you might say that this is a list. That's why there is no additional information available about the information it holds. If we use a dictionary, using the key value pairs, we can comprehend what kind of data is that data type holding, right? Okay, let's do it that way. So now when we translate this to a dictionary, it does give us much more information. Now we know what each number means. So we have a width, length, weight, and cost. Of course, this is much more clear now. But what if I add another key value pair here? Let's say color. And I assign it value red just to this only one dictionary. What does that say about these other two cars here? Should we add this key value pair individually to every dictionary? Well, now we only have three. What if the company has thousands of cars? How will we actually maintain a consistency in our data structure? Here is another dictionary, by the way. What do you think is the relationship between this dictionary and this dictionary? Are they related? Truth is, these are the upgraded versions of the above cars. But how would you have known if I hadn't told you? So, this is what I mean. Data types like lists, dictionaries, tuples, strings, set, these data types, the usual suspects if you will, they are not advanced or mature enough to hold complicated blueprints in them. To hold complicated data structures or blueprints as we call them, we need to use something as advanced as class. That way, we can store different kinds of information with different levels of complexity and perform different kinds of operations like encapsulation, polymorphism, inheritance, and other kinds of stuff as well. So, now that we know why class is essential, let's go ahead and see how can we work with class in Python. Now, we are going to design a car class. Let's start with the simplest design. A class consists of a header and a body. Let's write the header for the class car. So I can say class car, and that's it. You have to mention the class keyword and then the name of the class that you're interested in building. Now, if we are deriving our class from other classes, we can also write it like this with a parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis, we put down the name of the parent class. We will see examples of that in the inheritance video. Let's not worry about the body. I will just write the pass statement here. This basically means right now we don't care what goes inside the body. Let's now create an instance of the class. So using this blueprint here, we can create multiple cars. So I will say C1 equal to car. I'm going to call the car class and then print C1. Let's see what we are getting when we call the car class. Let's create another instance for comparison and do the same thing again. And I'll also print C2. All right. Let's go ahead, run this. When we print both the instances, this is what we see. Both the instances are car objects. This is the difference between a class and an object. Class is just a blueprint. An object is every instance built from that class. And both these objects are actually different entities. How can we be sure? Let's go ahead and see print C1 equal to C2. Let's see what we get. When we run this, it should return false, and it does, right? So basically both C1 and C2 are different entities derived from our blueprint called as car. Now, this is the basic definition of a class. Let's now add more info to our class. And what is that? Basically, we are going to talk about class attributes. What are class attributes? Class attributes are properties owned by a class. Do not confuse them with instance attributes. To give you an example, every car object coming out of this class here can have different color, right? Color is specific. Color is the property of the object. That is an instance attribute. But no matter what color, every car is a four-wheeler, right? That is a class attribute. The class attribute stays same for all objects coming out of the class. Let's see some examples. To define a class attribute, we can do something like this. So let's say we define a class attribute called as vehicle type. So I can say vehicle type and assign it four-wheeler, right? That's what the example we were talking about. Now, we can access the class attribute both through the class and the class instance. So here I can say print car, which is the class, dot vehicle type. This is accessing the class attribute through the class. And then if we create an instance of the class, let's say C1 equal to car, not small car, capital, and then print C1 dot vehicle type. We can also access the same class attribute through the instance. Let's go ahead and run this. Okay, so now you see for both the class and the class instance, we have the same class attribute. Let's do something. Like I mentioned, all the instances of the class share the same attribute, and this is exactly what you see. Now we can also alter the class attribute from outside the class. So here I can say car dot vehicle type equal to, let's say I want to change from four-wheeler to three-wheeler. All right. Now let's print the car dot vehicle type just to reassure ourselves. But then let's also print C1 dot vehicle type. Let's see if this value has changed after we have reassigned another value to car dot vehicle type. If we run this, so you see, both of them were four-wheelers first, and now even the C1 dot vehicle type is a three-wheeler because we changed the class attribute through the class method. Now, we can also change the value of the class attribute through the instance. But remember, if you change it that way, only the class attribute for the instance will change. For example, let's say instead of car dot vehicle type, I say C1 dot vehicle type. Here, C1 dot vehicle type equal to three-wheeler. Now, our class attribute is four-wheeler, but here we are changing the vehicle type just for the C1 instance. So now if I print it, okay, so four-wheeler, so initially the vehicle type for both the class and the instance is set to four-wheeler, then we change the vehicle type for only the instance, the C1. And when we print car dot vehicle type now, we get four-wheeler, which stays the same. But for C1, it's now three-wheeler. That means the blueprint still is not changing. That's why if you ever want to change the blueprint, or if you want to change the class attribute for the whole class, you should access, or you should change the attribute through the class, not the class instance. Remember this. Now, if you want to see all the class attributes for a specific class, we can use the dict data model. So basically, let's get rid of all of this. So let's define some more class attributes here. So we can say after vehicle type, I can say company equal to BMW. Let's have these two only. Now if I print car dot dict, alright, double underscore dict double underscore, if we print this, we can easily see what all key value pairs are there. So here you see we have the vehicle type and we have the company. Let's say you are importing a class from a different module. You can easily use this method to check for every attribute, every class attribute present in that class. Now guys, I hope this video was useful to you in terms of learning about Python class and class attributes. If you really like what I'm doing and if you have suggestions for how I can do it better, make sure to give me your feedback through the poll and also support me on Patreon. You can find the link to my Patreon page in the description below. Subscribe to the channel and I will see you in the next video.